Chapter 3. Odds and logarts. Now, let's dive into mathematical details of logistic regression. First, let's see what odds and logarts are. These are important concepts to understand logistic regression. Logistic regression is a statistical model used to predict binary outcomes based on one or more predictor variables. Unlike linear regression, which predicts continuous outcomes, logistic regression focuses on probabilities and classification. The goal of logistic regression is to estimate the probability of an event occurring. We denote this probability as P. The complementary probability is 1 minus P. That is, the probability of an event not occurring is 1 minus P. The ratio of P to 1 minus P is called odds. In other words, odds is the probability that an event will occur divided by the probability that it will not occur. Let's see some examples. When an event has 50% probability of occurring, there's a 50% probability that the event will not occur. In this case, the odds is 0.5 divided by 1 minus 0.5, so it is 1. When the odds is 1, the probability of this event occurring and the probability of it not occurring are equal. When the odds is 1, it indicates that the probability of the event occurring is equal to the probability of it not occurring. Essentially, it's a balanced situation where both outcomes are equally likely. When an event has 75% probability of occurring, the probability that the event will not occur is 25%. In this case, the odds is 3. The odds of 3 means that the probability of this event occurring is 3 times greater than the probability of it not occurring. Logistic regression modeling uses logarts rather than odds. The logarts are the logarithm of the odds of the probability of an event occurring. Logarts are also called logit functions. The following is a detailed explanation of logarts. Let's visualize the odds as a line plot. The x-axis represents p, and the y-axis is the odds. Since p on the x-axis is probability, it takes values from 0 to 1. Odds take some values from 0 to infinity. Unlike odds, logarts take on any value from negative infinity to positive infinity. When p is 0.5, the odds are 1. The logarts, which is the logarithm of the odds, is a natural logarithm of 1, and its value is 0. Therefore, the line graph of logarts passes through the point where x is 0.5 and y is 0. Around this point, the graph of logarts has symmetry. In other words, when the probability p of an event occurring and the probability 1 minus p of not occurring are reversed, the logarts values has the same absolute value and the sign is reversed. This property is important in logistic regression. Let's illustrate the symmetry of logarts with a simple example. As an example, let us calculate the odds and the logarts according to the number of positive cases out of 10. When there are equal numbers of positive and negative cases, the odds is 1. As the number of positive cases increases, the odds approaches infinity. And as the number of negative cases increases, the odds approaches 0. The ratio of positive to negative cases is opposite for the case where 9 out of 10 cases are positive and the case where 1 out of 10 cases are positive. In terms of odds, the former is 9 and the latter is 0.11. Converting this to logarithms yields 0.95 and minus 0.95, the same absolute value but opposite signs. In other cases, when the ratio of positive to negative is opposite, the logarithms are the same in absolute value and opposite in sign. This is due to the fact that in cases where the ratio of positive to negative is opposite, the value of the target being logarithmically transformed is inverse. In other words, it is the relationship between log x and log 1 divided by x. Since log x is equal to minus log 1 divided by x, the logarithms are symmetric. Logarithms are symmetrical when the odds is greater than 1 or less than 1, that is, when there are more positive cases or more negative cases. This property is useful in interpreting the results of logistic regression. Let's look again at the line graph of the odds. When p is 0.5, that is, where the number of positive and negative cases is equal, the odds are 1. After this point, the odds increases slightly as p increases. As p increases further, the odds rises infinitely rapidly. This figure is similar to the graph of the exponential function expressed in terms of the Napier number e to the x power. Thus, the odds are exponential in nature. Using logarithms allows us to model exponential phenomena in a linear relationship that is easier to understand. To model the odds as an exponential function, we can write an equality that considers the odds as an exponential function. In the equation e squared by x, which is an exponential function, x can take on any value. Suppose that this x is represented by the equation beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta n xn. You can think of this equation as similar to linear regression, where xi are the predictors and beta is the coefficient of each predictor. By substituting this x for the x power of e, which is an exponential function, you can obtain the equation for this complex exponential function. Log transforming both sides of this equality yields the logarithms on the left side and the log of exponential function on the right side. The log transformation of the exponential function is equal to the exponent of the original exponential function. Thus, the logarithms are beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta n xn. In other words, the logarithms can be expressed as a linear combination of the predictors.